Mm-hmm. Right. All right. I'll be with you in just a moment, okay? All right, thanks. Yeah, I have someone who just showed up into the office. Yeah, that'd be great, actually. What do you say we pick up? Just check my schedule. Say, tomorrow, same time. Does that work for you? Yeah, I could do then instead. Okay, great. And I'll talk to you then. Bye. Sorry about that. Keith Hollister, Arkham PI. So how can I help you? Are you okay? Is there a reason you don't wish to speak? Are you in any immediate danger? Do you need any medical assistance? Okay. You sure? All right. Because I was just going to suggest you might want to visit the Arkham, hospital in the emergency room. There's anything life-threatening. Okay. You sure you're in the right place? I'm a private detective. Usually folks come to me when they want help resolving some issues that they would prefer not to go to the police with. Okay. I hope this doesn't come off the wrong way, but you are capable of speaking. Yes, okay. So I'm assuming you're here because you need my help with something. Yes, okay. All right. Well, I'll take some information from you. Might be a little difficult if you're not willing to speak, but that's fine. I've had cases like yours before. It just might make things a little difficult and time-consuming. Okay. All right. Well, this is the first time we've met and you're being here. Why don't I just help make you feel a little more at ease and comfortable? You seem a little tense. Yeah, here. Yeah. I got something for you. How would you care for some paper cups? I find these make a really nice, pleasant sound. And whenever I'm stressed out, and believe me, my job is very stressful, I find these help immensely. Seem to help you a little bit. All right, let me just set these aside. So little things like that, that you could do throughout the day, that I found that, helps you to calm down a little bit. All right. Why don't I tell you a little bit about myself and the agency that I run here. I was a former detective at the Arkham Police Department, but I resigned just a little over 8 years now, and I set up this place, decided to take a crack at it. You know, going out on my own, I wasn't quite happy with the methods that they use at the Arkham PD. I've been pretty successful in resolving a lot of the cases. Folks like yourself come in to see me, whether it's reporting something, how little it might be, stolen merchandise, theft, to something more, severe and heinous. So I have about an 80-20 success rate. There's always those cases that just remain unsolved for various reasons. But I treat each client as if they were my only client. So you'll get from me the personal attention that you might not get from the Arkham PD, okay? That means you can call me at any time, with new information, leads, etc. Feel free to come into my office at any time as well during, normal business hours, which I'm pretty much here morning, noon, and night. Okay, so I hope that helps give you a little peace of mind, and as far as, who I am and that you've come to the right place. Okay, so what is it that brings you here? I know you don't wish to speak, so I'm going to have to, lead you with questions that will elicit a yes or no response from you. Just nod your head, shake your head, okay? Shrug if you're not sure. So are you here to report something that you wish not to report to the police? All right, so what is it that exactly that you wish to have me investigate for you? Is it a crime, theft, some kind of domestic incident? Do you recognize the individuals in these photos? You do? Huh. Okay. Is that why you're here? All right. Okay, give me a moment. Allow me a moment to sharpen my pen. Something wrong with this sharpener. Doesn't seem to sharpen my pen like it used to. Not like it does my pencils, at least. Okay, just get my notebook here. Okay. So, you happen to be familiar with the subjects in these photos. Well, I wish I could say you're the only one, but I've been having a lot of cases recently, just like you, coming in here, different folks, actually. If you look down in the comments, all those different names that you see, a lot of them are folks, you know, using, hiding behind the safety of anonymity, who are also familiar with the individuals in these photos. So you're not the only one. But this is a high profile case that I've been working on. If you take a closer look, all these folks, I believe, are somehow tied to someone or something. Now, there does appear to be a ringleader, but I believe that there is even someone or something above him that a lot of individuals have been coming to me reporting strange incidents and happenings at this place called Arkham Sanitarium. I see your eyes lighting up there and you're nodding. Okay, so you're familiar with that place. All right. Yeah, so I don't know what it is, but I just have this feeling that there is this unknown entity, if you will, behind this investigation of mine, which actually takes up most of my cases, most of my time. And it seems to have a lot of ties with, you know, these individuals and, you know, almost everyone that, you know, walks in here. A lot of things that I wouldn't expect to have ties. And now I can see, speaking of which, it looks like even you have ties. To whatever it is. Yeah. You can see I put a big question mark because I'm not really sure, you know, who or what is behind everything. It even has ties to this microphone. Can you see that right here? Yeah. It even has ties to that, so just put that back. Okay. And I hope you don't mind the microphone. I use it as a backup, you know, record all the conversations that I have in the event that, you know, I forget some details. All right. Okay. All right. And, you know, before we get into everything, you can see all the ties, and I've been trying to connect the dots, but I'm having a little bit of trouble. I started to connect the dots early on, but became a little increasingly difficult. Maybe you might be able to help me connect the dots. Maybe that's something that we can do later, okay? All right. let's get back to the reason that you're here. Okay. All right. Now I know you don't wish to speak, and that's fine. Do you wish to divulge your name at all at this time? No? Okay, that's fine. That's, can always get that later on in the investigation, okay? Are you a current resident of Arkham? Okay, yes. Have you lived here all your life? No. That doesn't surprise me. In the cases that I've been taking in regards to this high-profile case I'm working on, it seems that many of the individuals, like yourself, are either new to the town of Arkham, or they're vagrants, transients, drifters, and the like. Okay. All right, so you haven't been here all your life. Did you move here for a specific reason or purpose? No? Okay. Did you feel compelled to move here? Yes. Mm-hmm. Would you say you felt drawn here to Arkham? Okay. Did you happen to have any dreams about it? About coming here, about this town before you moved here? Okay. Do you have any family or friends that are aware that you moved here? Okay. What about any employers? Were you working before or after you moved here? Okay. Let's talk about why you're here. So, you're not in any immediate danger, is that correct? No. Okay, you're not sure, but okay, not that you're aware of. All right. Do you know if you're being followed or stalked by anyone, especially any of the individuals in these photographs behind me? Okay. Has anyone threatened you? Okay. No. All right. So you're here because of the individuals, some of them, in these photographs? Are you here because of all of them? Yes, okay. Did any of these individuals harm you? No. Are any of these individuals in these photographs family or friends to you? No. Okay. Did you work for or with any of these individuals are. They your employers, co-workers? No. So let's recap, just to make sure I understand so far. So, you felt compelled or drawn to move here to Arkham. I'm not really sure why. You've even had a dream or two. No one knows that you've moved here. And then, at some point, you became familiar with these individuals, you know, in the photographs behind me. Is that an accurate statement so far? Okay. And none of them harmed you? Okay. Right. It's quite similar to some of the other individuals that have come in here to report some information about these, well, might as well call them suspects. Let me show you. You might be familiar. Normally, I don't like to, share confidential case information or the identity of individuals that have come to me looking for help, but in this particular instance I think I can make an exception. Here is someone that came in here not too long ago. Charlie Bags, I believe that's how the individual spells their name. Does this? Okay, you're nodding your head. So you are familiar with this individual? I see. Charlie Bags was a patient at Arkham Sanitarium. You're nodding your head. Did you happen to be a patient too? Okay. All right. When Mr. Bags first showed up here, he wasn't doing too well. They did some horrible things to him. But, well, I can happily say he's doing much better these days. He was just in here last week. He has a wife, a couple kids. It's a good thing to see. So, yeah. But, yeah, good old Charlie. All right. Let's get back to you, all right? Okay, so let's find out how you know about these suspects. You are familiar with Arkham Sanitarium. I think we established that. And you said you were a patient at the sanitarium, okay. And we've already stated not employed there. You were a patient, you weren't visiting anyone there, okay. Sanitarium, you're a patient there. How did you end up at Arkham Sanitarium? Through one of these individuals? Okay. Did one of them talk to you? Okay. All right, how about I point to the photo, and then you tell me which individual it was that was responsible for your, going to Arkham Sanitarium. Okay. Was it any of the ones on this side? No. How about any of the ones over here? Yeah? Okay. Just nod when I get close, right? Yeah. That individual? You sure? That doesn't surprise me. That is Thomas, the kind napper. Okay. He is a very elusive individual. I have tried to track him down, but he moves from place to place. Apparently, what he does is kidnaps folks and then transports them somehow to Arkham Sanitarium. But the reason he's called the kind napper is that he doesn't do any harm, and he actually treats his victims, captives, well. He feeds them, helps them to relax, and then eventually sedates them, and the next thing they know, they wake up as a patient at Arkham Sanitarium. So does that sound... Okay, you're nodding your head. That's exactly what happened to you. Okay. So you were kind, napped. Well, you're definitely not the first, and unfortunately, you probably won't be the last. Did anyone mistreat you while you're at the sanitarium? No, or is that not really? Let me put it to you this way. Were you subjected to any experiments? You were. Okay. And were these experiments harmful to you? No. Did you actually enjoy these experiments? Yes. Okay. Yeah, that's a common thread among many of the cases like yours. And Charlie Bags, too. Unfortunately. Unfortunately, in Charlie's case, they weren't quite as benevolent as they may have been with you. All right. Would you say prior to your arrival at Arkham Sanitarium, that you weren't very happy with your life. For the most part. Okay. And then would you say, after your arrival to Arkham, and then most especially when she became a patient at Arkham Sanitarium, that your life became better and you were happier? Yes, okay. And you were happy even when they were performing experiments on you. Okay. Yeah, again, that seems to be a common thread among all the individuals, the victims, so to speak, in this case. Okay, why don't we recap again, just to make sure I'm on the same page. So, your life back home prior to moving to Arkham was not quite ideal. Say, okay, you weren't quite as happy as you wanted to be. Okay. You started to have some dreams about Arkham. Maybe a dream about Arkham Sanitarium. Strange faces you've never seen before. Okay. And then you felt compelled and drawn to move here to Arkham. Is that right? Yeah. So you arrive here, find a place to live. By the way, where did you end up taking residence? Okay. There was another individual who hasn't come to me reporting a case, but goes by the name of the Arkham Vlogger. Again, just like you and a lot of the other individuals in this case, felt compelled to move here to Arkham. But what he's doing is vlogging. It's a video blog. He's doing it on a video sharing site. It's a very popular one. I've seen the first one, the first episode. I don't think he's uploaded any others since, but but back to you. So you ended up taking residence here in Arkham, and then at some point you were kidnapped by Thomas the kidnapper. You end up at Arkham Sanitarium. They perform various experiments on you, and you feel your life has improved. And now you're here. Is that the gist of it? Yeah, okay. Now, before we get into any details about the sanitarium, do you remember the date and time of, before you ended up at the sanitarium, when you were kidnapped? Any recollection of when that was? No? Okay, maybe not at this time. Maybe it'll come to you. If it does, just, give me a call or stop in the office. All right, so you're here. You were at Arkham Sanitarium. How did you end up here? Did you leave Sanitarium? Was it by your own volition? Your own choice? No? Okay. Were you asked or forced to leave by any of the individuals there? No? Okay. Did someone help you leave? Yes, okay. Would you go so far as to say you escaped from Arkham Sanitarium? Okay. Do you know who helped you escape? No. Okay. You don't know who it was. Do you know what they look like? They were wearing a mask. Okay. You can just see their eyes. All right. Okay, mask. Do you happen to know what eye color? Brown, black, blue, hazel. Okay. Do you think this person that helped you escape was also a patient? You're not sure? Okay. Maybe an employee? Yeah, not sure. Yeah, I'm not really sure how relevant to this case that individual is, but still like to make sure we take as much details. Why do you think they helped you escape? I think it might have been out of empathy, sympathy, maybe some other ulterior motive. You don't know. Let me ask you this. Did you want to leave? No. It's interesting. It's the same answer in all these cases. You end up here. They experiment on you. They don't cause you any harm. And then, for whatever reason, someone helps you escape. It's quite baffling. All right, I really want to thank you for coming in and, you know, cooperating thus far. You know, even though I know you're not willing to speak, it's fine. Maybe, you know, at another time. You know, if you want, we can take a break right now. I know we've been here for quite some time, but you okay? You're fine. Okay. All right. Well, I'll continue if that's all right with you. All right. You seem to be getting a little drowsy. That's fine. Just relax, you know. Everything's okay. Just want to ask you some more details, and then you can feel free to just relax, maybe fall asleep in that chair. I know it's quite comfortable. All right. So let's talk about some of the individuals in these photos that you might be familiar with. Are you familiar with Professor Clemens? Also known as William Clemens. That's his real name, supposedly. Okay. Margaret Clemens. Okay. Iggy Manley. Okay. Martha Stewart. She appears to have some relation Not really quite sure how. Okay. Individual known as Grandpa. All right. Charlie Carl, another patient. Okay. And then we have this individual here is a sentient rhinoceros by the name of Sawande. Familiar? Okay. Dr. Frank Walker, another employee of Arkham Sanitarium. Okay. Patient by the name of Green Man. Okay. All right, you're already familiar with Thomas. We have this individual here wearing a mask known as the Man of Bats. You familiar with him? Okay. Then we have this individual here known as Kevin, a.k.a. Cthulhu. He's some deity, ancient elder god, old one, that Professor Clemens and perhaps some others helped to raise up from its slumber, the bottom of the Pacific. Okay, all right. And then how about some of the individuals over on this side? Up top we have Corvus Clemens, who appears to appear in different disguises or outfits. Okay. We have this gentleman who runs the Tinfoil Hat Society. You're familiar with him? Okay. Somehow he's involved in all this. Not really quite sure. From what I understand, there are some individuals who believe that he actually keeps watch on Professor Clemens and everyone else. We have another individual over here by name of Comrade Yuri. He's a communist spy, apparently. Okay. Let's see. We have this individual known as Deep One Dave. You familiar with him? Okay. Not only does he appear to be employed at Arkham Sanitarium as a doctor, but also runs a thrift shop over in Innsmouth, the neighboring town. Familiar with that place? Okay. And then we have a mall cop. We have this patient, we believe, called Bag Thing. And then another employee, Dr. Lampert Shade. Captain Carter, who lives in Cardboard Town, somehow also has ties to whatever the, you know, entity is behind all this. And then we have Death, and then ASMR Man. Not really sure his involvement, but again, does have ties. So, you are familiar with most of these individuals, okay? All right, well, I think that's going to be all the information that I need for now. We've been here long enough. I don't want to take up too much more of your time. So, just look at some of the other notes, some of the other cases here. Okay. All right. I think that will do it for today, if that's all right with you. Finalize my notes, and then, you know, you're free to, you know, just relax a little bit. But I will need to ask you to leave once you've, you you know, got your rest, all right? And then maybe you can come back another time and we can discuss this some more. Maybe there'll be, you know, go back to your residence if that's where you plan on going. Okay. Do you have any money or anything? Okay, I'll help you out before you go. Okay? Get you something to get back on your feet. I know of a little safe house that you could stay at. Okay? Some of the other patients are there as well. Okay, and then rest your mind and maybe some things will come back to you. You can come back here and, you know, we'll get some more details on the case. Alright, and hopefully find out who or what is behind it all. And what involvement Professor Clemens, Corvus, and everyone has with it. Alright, okay. Again, thank you for your cooperation. Alright, it was a pleasure to meet you. I'm just going to finalize some notes here, okay?